Good morning, everyone. It's Michael Carwin here. How are you? Can everyone hear me okay?
Yeah, I can hear you. Jim Beattie here.
Jim, how are you? That's great. Okay, well, what I'm going to do is I'm going to start off by giving everyone a run through, pretty much just transferring from Buildsoft to either Buildsoft and then to other formats like Excel, PDF, and site format. And then as part of that, showing you how you use the new backup and restore function in version 2010 that went out. So what I'll do is I'll flick off the sound so we don't get any feedback during that run through. And then we'll turn it back on at the end so anyone can ask any questions. But if anything pops up that you need to find out and you want to ask straight away, there's a small text box for everyone down the right-hand side of the GoToMeeting window that you can use and just send me a message. And you can either send it direct to me using private or to everyone so everyone can see. Okay, so I'll just quickly hit the mute for you. So you, I think, Jim, you're the only one with a speaker, so you won't be able to hear. So just text me if need be. Okay, so what we'll do is I'll begin by just showing you how we, pretty much how you transfer from Buildsoft out to, say, if you were sending someone a bill, so you know how to, you can email it to them. And then also how you might export a job from Buildsoft to something like Excel, PDF, or even a format called Site, which is a construction industry format that was designed to transfer between two build production systems or two estimating systems. And then what I'll give you an example of is then how you import from those sort of systems, as in bringing back in a Buildsoft file that you get on email, and then also how you might import an Excel or Site file back into Buildsoft for yourself. So I suppose the most common format to export from Buildsoft would be sending a Buildsoft file to someone via email. Now, thankfully to the guys in Buildsoft have made it a little bit easier now. If you use Microsoft Outlook or Outlook Express on your PC, the new version 2010 has a built-in Outlook procedure, so you can actually back up and send via email in one function. So how you would do that is from your job manager screen, as you can see, you would highlight your job as normal. You would choose backup from your job manager screen. That will give you an option to say, you know, please choose one of the methods. You've got normal, you've got external, and you've got cancel. You've also got your backup option. So depending on what you would like to send the person, you choose the relevant option. So if you want to, if you've got a job that has buildups of quantities, so you've got information on the cal sheet, and then you've got also information on the rate buildup sheet, you can choose to exclude those options down the bottom here. So do you see the way down the bottom, you've got exclude cal sheets and exclude rate breakup sheets. So what you're able to do there is you can actually tick those options, and that will make a copy of the job to send to somebody excluding the buildup. So the person would only be able to see the total quantity and the total rate. So you wouldn't actually be able to see where you got your workings from. And you've also got two options here, normal and then external. So normal is a full backup, which includes price lift references if you use the price book procedure. And also then if anyone has the BTOS system, which is the on-screen takeoff module, that would include that information in it as well. But if you don't want to include your BTOS buildup or any reference to a price book you might have done, use the external option. So my rule normally is that if you're sending an external out of your practice, you should use the external option. So you click external with the options ticked, and that will actually go through a motion. Now what you'll notice in the background is you'll see that it actually makes a copy of your job at the top here, and I'll show you what that looks like now in a second. Now what you have is with the new Buildsoft utilities, you see the version 5.09, you've got your path where you want to back it up to, where you're able to browse and select folders. And as you can see in the new one, it's a lot easier to select the folders in which you'll back up to. Okay, So they're all there for you. So you can choose wherever you'd like to back it up to. Choose OK, and then you can hit backup. Now, what you'll also notice is now we've got this new option, send via email with the word Outlook in it. Okay. Now, what that allows you to do is that will actually back up the job for you, but also create an email and attach the file in one go for it. So we'll tick that option. We'll hit backup. And it's just saying it already exists because I've already done it earlier on in the same webinar. So I'll just say yes to that, which is fine. And what that does is that goes through a motion. It creates the email in Outlook for me, gives it a subject of just Buildsoft backup files, and attaches the backup automatically for you. And as you can see, a backup of a Buildsoft file is the extension E0X. So if you receive one, you know it's a Buildsoft file. So in the body of the email, you can just put your own text as normal, like dear sir, please find attached copy of Buildsoft file. Regards. So whatever you want to say in the email, you can do it. But the attachment is already there. And then you just type in your email address as normal, and that will automatically come onto your email account. And then you can just send that as you normally would. Okay. Now that will work if you have Microsoft Outlook or Outlook Express attached or set up on your PC and you use that for your email. If you use something like Gmail or Aircom Webmail, where you log on to the internet and then log into an email account, you need to actually back up the file and then attach it through that system, because we can't access Webmail accounts because you've got to access somebody else's website. So if in that case, what you do is you just back up the job as normal. But instead of saying backup, send via email, you choose a path. So let's say we say webinar files and Buildsoft files, I'll call it, and you hit backup. That'll go through the motion, and then your backup is complete for you. Okay. Now, if you want to see where that file goes to, you just go browse to the location you had the file. So I had it in my C drive in my webinars folder, and then into Buildsoft files was the folder I had it in. So when we go in there, we can see the files that we have, and there's all EOX files in there, and you can see the one from today. See example 11 E0X, it has today's date with the timestamp on it. So then you can just attach that as you would normally to a webmail email account. But if you have an Outlook email account, you can now use it direct to through Buildsoft. Now, that's not to say that if you have Outlook, you can still attach it as normal by opening up your email, going to new, and then attaching it as normal and just browsing to your file that you would always do. So you can still do your old method that you were using, but it has made it slightly easier if you want to use it, and you just attach your file as normal by hitting insert, and that will attach your file for you. Okay, so you know, you can use either one, but the built-in feature now has an option for ourselves. Did someone just ask there? Okay, I'm just going to pause there for one sec, because I've just been getting a question because Anna can't hear me. So she just has the wrong setting. So I'm just going to type a message, if you can bear with me for one sec. Sorry about that, just Anna can't hear me there for a sec. Okay, so as I was saying, so when you're sending out the file to it, you know, the new backup procedure, you can choose normal, and then you can just choose send via email Outlook, and that will create it for you. Now, bringing a job back in from an email back into Buildsoft, What you need to do is you need to save the file from your email to a location. So you will receive an EOX file from someone. You just attach, save that onto your C drive or onto a memory stick or even onto a network share if you have one, and you'll see the E0X file save into the location. From there then, you open Buildsoft to your job manager screen, and if you use the project mode, you open up the project that you've already got in there. So you come in then to your job manager, you click restore. Now you'll notice with the new restore procedure as well, it makes it a little easier in that when you select the folder, so you're selecting your folder is easier. You can then go in, choose the folder where you want, where it's saved to. So it doesn't matter where you've saved it to, you just browse to wherever it is. When you select the folder, the new procedure will automatically refresh the list. So you don't have to choose the Get Details button anymore. It'll pop up with all the Buildsoft files in there. And then you just restore the file that you wish to use. So you got your example one, which is backed up on the 12th of the 7th. Hit restore. And that automatically adds the list, adds the job onto the list that you're looking at. Now, when we were sending out the files, we were talking about excluding backups of the calc sheets and the rate buildup sheets. Now, the person who sends you the job could also do that. So when you go in, your quantities may just be typed in a black piece, a black color. So it means the person has hid them for you. So as you can see, sending a job from Buildsoft is the easiest method because it's like for like systems. You may at a time need to send a job from Buildsoft to a different format, such as Excel, such as PDF, or even such as Cite, C-I-T-E format, or EBQ is what other people refer it to. So to do that then, we'll talk about Excel first, because that's probably the most common question we get asked. So there's two ways you can do it. So you begin by obviously opening up your job. So we highlight the job and we hit open. And that'll open it up onto the job summary level. Now from there then, there's two ways you can do it. There's a copy and paste method, which I'll show you first. And then there's also the print drop down menu method where you can export one of the reports direct to Excel. So before I go on, I'll just quickly open up Excel. So I'll click on my start. I'll open up Excel as normal, just for the copy and paste method to make it easier. Okay, so when you want to use the copy and paste method, you can basically copy the page you're on or the level you're on in Buildsoft from there direct into Excel. So at the moment, I'm on the job summary level. So if I wanted to export this level out to Excel, I would highlight or tag the lines I would like to export. I do this by coming along, left-clicking on my number at the left. So you can click and hold down your left mouse button, and with your left mouse button held, you can slide down along the left, which will tag certain items. Okay, so you can choose which ones you want. Now, another tip for people would be if you wanted to have a certain amount of them, so you only wanted certain, so you wanted those three, then skip those ones and come along and select line 7, 8, and 9. What you need to do is on your keyboard, you would have a button called CTRL, control. If you hold that, keep that pressed, you can then left click on the lines you wish to tag or select. That's a lot easier than dragging because you could be up and down. So if you, at any stage, you just hold down the control key and then left click on the line numbers you wish to select. If you're wishing to choose everything, an easier way is actually